Once again, I welcome on the class of Geotechnical Engineering. So in the last video, I have discussed about the field compaction method, and I have discussed the various field compaction methods, and after that I have discussed the problems based on the compaction. So today I will discuss the new module, that is the vertical stresses due to the applied loads. And in this module I will discuss the what is the Bozanes theory and what is the Westergaard theory, and after that what is the expression of vertical stress due to point load by the Bozanes theory, and the due to the point load the vertical stress by the Westergaard theory. And then I will compare the Bozanes theory with the Westergaard theory. So let us start about the vertical stresses below the applied load. So vertical stresses in soil is either due to the self weight of the soil or due to the applied loads. So here in this module I will discuss the vertical stress due to the applied load. So the first theory based on this approach, that is the Bozanes equation. So Bozanes in 1885, Bozanes has given the expression of vertical stress sigma z due to point load Q at a point P whose coordinate is R and Z, means at a radial distance R and at a depth Z. Before that I will discuss the assumption. So various assumption taken by the So the first assumption is soil is homogeneous and isotropic. Second assumption is soil mass is elastic. And the third one is soil is semi-infinite. Semi-infinite means the depth is finite and our area, soil area is infinite, or we can see that depth is known or area is soil area of soil mass is unknown. So that's why the assumption is taken as semi-infinite. The self weight of soil is negligible. So here the self weight of the soil is assumed to be zero. So let us assume this is our ground surface and this is the point where applied load Q is acting, and this is the point where we have to find the so I have taken the point P. So let us name this P, and this P has a coordinate. This distance is Z and the radial distance is R. So this point we have to compute the vertical stress sigma Z, and the coordinate of this point is R is the radial distance and the Z is the vertical distance or vertical coordinate of this point P. So according to Bozanes equation, vertical stress sigma z is equal to kb into q by z square, where kb is the Bozanes इन्फ्लुएंस फैक्टर विच इज द फंक्शन ऑफ, सो के बी इज द फंक्शन ऑफ आर बाई जेड and the expression of Bosnian influence factor is equal to 3 by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus r by z to the whole square to the power 5 by 2. So this is the expression of Bosnian influence factor, and we know that q is the point load, z is the depth, and sigma z is the vertical stress. So this is the function. This is the equation of vertical stress. So similarly, if I compute the vertical stress just below the load. So if I compute the vertical stress at this point, means the value of r by z, r is equal to 0. So vertical stress just below the point load means the value of r is equal to 0, means r by z is equal to 0. So if I compute the value of kb is equal to 3 by 2 pi into 1 by 1 plus r by z whole square to the power 5 by 2. So this value r is 0 means it will be 3 by 2 pi. So if I compute the value 0.4775. So the vertical stress just below the point load is 0.4775 q by z square. Where sigma z is the vertical stress just below the point load. So we can see that the vertical stress is the function of r by z. So at certain depth, the vertical stress is the only function of r by z, and it is independent of the elastic property, like material property like Young's modulus of elasticity and Poisson's ratio. So here we can see that once the r by z value is increasing, the value of Bosnian influence factor is decreasing, and we can see that approximately when r by z is equal to 10, the value is approximate value of kb is equal to 0. Means we can say that once the r by z value is increasing, the Bosnian influence factor is decreasing and the vertical stress is also decreases. So if I write here, vertical stress is depends on the r by z ratio and is independent of Young's modulus of elasticity and Poisson's ratio. Value of sigma z is decreases when r by z value is increases. The value of sigma z is very small when r by z is greater than 5, and the value is approximately equal to 0 when r by z is equal to 10. So when the value of sigma z is very small, when r by z ratio is greater than 5 and the value is approximately equal to 0 when r by z is equal to 10. So let us start the another method to compute the vertical stress due to point load at any depth z and radial distance r. That is the Westergaard equation. So Westergaard has given the theoretical solution for vertical stress in 1938. And the various assumptions taken by the Westergaard, like the soil mass is anisotropic and the soil mass is elastic, semi-infinite. And this formula, Westergaard has given the expression to compute the vertical stress for the stratified soil. Or we can say that Westergaard's equation is most suitable for the stratified soil. And in this equation, the Poisson's ratio of the soil will be 0. And formula is applicable for the stratified soil. According to Westergaard equation, the vertical stress sigma z is equal to kw into q by z square, where Kw is the Westergaard influence factor, and once again it is the function of r by z. So Westergaard influence factor is 1 by pi into 1 by 1 plus 2 into r by z whole square to the power 3 by 2. So this is the expression of Westergaard influence factor, 1 by pi 1 into 1 divided by 1 plus 2 into r by z whole square to the power 3 by 2. And q is the point load, sigma z is the vertical stress, and z is the depth, r is the radial distance. So what we have observed that when r by z is equal to 1.5, at that times Poisson's influence factor is exactly equal to the Westergaard influence factor. When r by z is less than equal to 1.5, then Poisson's influence factor is greater than Westergaard influence factor. Or we can see that the vertical stress computed by the Poisson's is more as compared to the Westergaard. And when r by z is greater than 1.5, then Westergaard influence factor is more than the Poisson's influence factor. It is also observed that the Westergaard theory is most realistic with the most suitable for the field condition, but the Poisson's theory will give the conservative results. That's why the Poisson's equation is oftenly used in the used to compute the vertical stress for different types of problem. So we can write here Westergaard equation is very common with the field problem, but Poisson's theory gives conservative results. That's why Poisson's theory is more common as compared to the Westergaard equation. So let us discuss the few problems. The first question I have taken, and this is asked in GATE 2003. A 25 kN point load acts on the surface of an infinite elastic medium. The vertical pressure intensity in kN per meter square at a point 6 meter below and 4 meter away from the loading will be. So here if I make the diagram, so Let us assume this is our ground surface and a point load of 25 kilonewton acts, and this is the point where we have to find the vertical stress, and it is 6 meter below. So this is 6 meter and this is 4 meter. We have to compute the if I write the coordinates, so it will be 4 and 6. We have to find the vertical stress sigma z at this point, and the capital Q is given, that is 25 kilonewton. So according to Bosinus equation, according to Bosinus Bosinus equation, sigma z is equal to kb into q by z square, where kb is equal to 3 by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus r by z whole square to the power 5 by 2. So if I compute the Bosinus influence factor, so it will be 1 by 1 plus r by z is 4 by 6 means 2 by 3. So 4 by 6 whole square to the power 5 by 2. So if I compute the value of Bosinus influence factor, so it will be 3 divided by 2 pi into 1 divided by 1 plus 16 by 36 to the power 2.5. So the Bosinus influence factor is 0.19. 0.19. So vertical stress sigma z is 0.19 into point load is given. It is 25. So 25 divided by z square. So it will be 36. So it will be 0.19 into 25 divided by 36. So it is 0.132. So it is 0.132 kilonewton per meter square. So if I see the option, so it will be D option is correct. So let us take the another problem. The vertical stress at a point P1, so this point is P1, due to the point load Q on the ground surface is shown in the figure, is sigma z. So this point, the vertical stress is sigma z. According to Bosinus equation, the vertical stress at point P2, this point we have to find the vertical stress. So if I write at point P1, sigma z is equal to kb into q by z square, and the value of kb is 3 by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus radial distance is r and depth is z whole square to the power 5 by 2 into q by z square. And at point P2, we can compute sigma z is equal to once again kb into q by z square. So if I compute the Bosinus influence factor, so it will be 1 by 1 plus r by 2 divided by z by 2 whole square to the power 5 by 2 into q by z by 2 whole square. So it will be 2 to cancel, so it will be 3 by 2 pi sigma z dash 3 by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus r by z whole square to the power 5 by 2 into 4 q by z square, and 3 by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus r by z whole square to the power 5 by 2 into q by z square is sigma z. So we can write sigma z is equal to 4 times the sigma z, means vertical stress at point P2 will be the 4 times the vertical stress at point P1. So our option D is correct. Let us take the another problem. So in the case of a stratified soil layer, the best equation that can be adopted for computing the pressure distribution is, so as I already discussed that for the stratified soil, Westergaard equation for stratified soil, Westergaard equation is most suitable. So another problem I am taking, that is the change in the vertical stress in the soil mass estimated by Bozness equation when Poisson's ratio of soil changes from 0.3 to 0.5 will be. So as I told you in the when I am discussing the Bozness equation, so I told you that the Bozness equation is dependent only upon the R by Z ratio and it is independent of the Young's modulus of elasticity and Poisson's ratio. So it is independent of, so if I write the solution, so Bozness equation is independent of E, Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio. So there will be no change in vertical stress by changing the Poisson's ratio. So our option D is correct. Let us take the another problem. So a concentrated load of 50 kN acts on the surface of a ground. The increase in vertical stress directly below the load at a depth of 4 meter will be. So directly below the load, so if I compute the stress, directly below means the value of Bozness influence factor is given 0.48. If it is not given, so the value will be directly 3 by 2 pi. So this is the load 50 kN and we have to find the vertical stress at this point at a depth of 4 meter. So this is the point where coordinate is 0, 4 meter. So at this point we have to find the vertical stress. So the vertical stress sigma z can be written as sigma z is equal to kb into q by z square. So the influence factor is 0.48 into load is 50 divided by 16. So the 0.48 into 50 by 4 square, so it is coming 1.5 kN per meter square. Let us take the another problem. A concentrated load of 50 ton acts vertically at a point on the soil surface. If Bozness equation is applied for computation of stress, then the ratio of vertical stress at a depth of 3 meter and 5 meter respectively below the point of application of load will be. So see, this is another very similar question. Let us assume this is our ground surface and a point load is acting, magnitude is 50 ton. So 50 ton magnitude, and we have to compute the vertical stress just below the point load but at a depth of 3 meter and 5 meter. Let us assume this point is 3 meter and 5 meter. So this depth is 3 meter and this is 5 meter. Let us assume this point is P1 and P2. So we have to find the vertical Bozness equation. We have to find the स्ट्रेस देन द रेशियो ऑफ वर्टिकल स्ट्रेस एट डेप्थ ऑफ 3 मीटर एंड 5 मीटर मीन्स एट पॉइंट पी वन एट पॉइंट पी वन सिग्मा जेड इज इक्वल टू के बी सो द पॉइजनस इन्फ्लुएंस फैक्टर विल बी सेम इट विल बी जस्ट बिलो द पॉइंट लोड दैट इज 0.4775 इंटू क्यू डिवाइडेड बाई 3 स्क्वायर और वी कैन राइट 0.4775 इंटू लोड इज 50 डिवाइडेड बाई 9 सिमिलरली एट पॉइंट क्यू इफ आई कंप्यूट एट पॉइंट पी टू सो इट विल बी सिग्मा जेड इज इक्वल टू 0.4775 into 50 divided by 25 so the ratio will be ratio of vertical stress will be if I compute so it will be this value cancel so 25 by 9 so the ratio will be ratio of vertical stress means sigma z at z is equal to 3 divided by vertical stress at z is equal to 5 is equal to 25 by 9 so it is 25 by 9 so it is coming 2.78 so d option is correct.